Hello and welcome back to Single Teenage Parents. Today we've gone along to this small rural community to have a look at a unique case of a single teenage father struggling to raise his one and only child. His wife left their child because he was a little bit different from others. And now, behind the closed doors in number 14, we have a look at how this single father is struggling to raise his one and only child in a competitive and harsh world.
I'm just on my way back from the job centre. I'm in desperate need to try and find a job to be able to run a car, pay for the house and food, and obviously to look after baby Pete. I can't afford a nanny, and obviously my wife has left me. She's my ex-wife, so there's no one to look after the child, or even, you know, I could look after the child, she can go and work with it, whichever, but I need to work, and I also need to look after baby Pete. So what I need to do is maybe find a friend who will look after him temporarily till I have some money to pay for a nanny, so then I can actually get a proper job, so then I'll be back on my feet, get back on track. It's just getting there, you know. I sort of feel like I'm in limbo at the moment. So it's difficult, but I'm getting there. Peter, I feel very irresponsible because I've actually had baby Pete asleep at home. Luckily, he stays asleep for up to 3 hours, and I've only been gone what, hour and a half or so he should still be asleep. But you know, anyone would say I'm a bad parent leaving him alone, but he doesn't really, you know, he doesn't get up to any trouble or anything like that. It's just hard.
Go check on
baby Pete. He should be fast asleep.
Strange,
I can hear the telly's on. Oh no. Oh. Hey, Peter.
He's falling asleep. Once upon a time.
Basically, what just happened a minute ago is I don't want to lie, it's very common that baby Peter gets out. He always finds some form of food. As you can see, he's big, and he's exactly 11 months old and 2 weeks. And when he was born, he was a normal sized baby, very healthy. And over the period of 3 weeks, he grew at the most incredible rate until now, at 11 months old, he's got to this size. Much earlier on, when my wife left me to look after him, she freaked out. She left one day. She just ran off, and here I am looking after him. It sounds like baby Pete's having a good time. It's got my mobile.
Things have quieted down now after baby Pete's tantrum earlier. His father has gone to check on him.
I think baby Pete's finally fallen asleep now, so I'll go and check on him. Admittedly, that was one of the bad tantrums that he's had, but he always gets my things, and he's so tall that he can actually reach them. I mean, he can stand every now and again, but you know, just worry that he's going to get cut or choke on something. Yeah, he's better put him back. He'll be all right like that. Come, let's leave him. Leave him alone.
Food, fire, fuel, and what are the things that, for a short while, you can suspend?
It's so nice to get some peace and quiet.
For a period of time, you can get away.
Don't cry.
After today's ordeals, little baby Peter's father has decided to take him to the duck pond.
I'm taking baby Pete down to the duck pond. He's always loved the ducks. It's just not looking. Peter, leave that alone. He's always loved it. Peter, please, I'm trying to drive. Look, put that back, okay? Just leave it alone. Pete, no. Peter, it's not raining. Please, leave those alone. No, Peter. No, boy, no, you do not touch the steering wheel. Tough journey, but we're finally here at the dike pond. Well, there aren't actually any ducks here today. It doesn't matter, because Peter looks for them anyway.
Peter! What are you doing? Peter!
Idiot! You stupid idiot! Peter!
Oh, God.
We caught up with little baby Pete's father later on.
Well, you see the sort of things I have to deal with. I mean, so far this is normal day things, and it's tough. I'm always worrying about little Peter, and I'm always worrying about my financial situation, you know, having to look after everything. But, you know, at the end of every storm there's blue skies.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real. The needle tears a hole, the old familiar sting. Try to kill it all away, but I remember everything.